Hey man, it's Premium with her Funny Nigga Harris. You can see me back with another video. Listen, my last video, I got a Money Bag Yo song. I reacted to that song he got with Polo G and Derek. It's called Free Promo. If you want to check that out, you can. And I also was talking about this album as well, like what I'm going to, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to go about this. So if you want to check that out, it's in my last video. You can go ahead and check that out. Money Bag Yo is really that guy. He's different. Memphis on, which is fire because I've been out there, used to, when I was younger, you feel me? But I haven't been traveling that much, you know what I'm saying? Niggas go through stuff, niggas grow up, you know what I'm saying? I ain't got time for that no more. I want this whole album to be crazy and go, you know what I'm saying, go smooth because, like I said, I got hopes and I know Bag Yo is like, he's that nigga. But like I said, I hate to, you know what I'm saying, come in, have to record a video to say this shit's my ass. I will do it if I got it to you, feel me? I ain't gonna lie to you, keep it a buck. But yeah, man, ain't finna talk your head off too much, you feel me? It's an album reaction, shit's already too long. So yeah, let me start talking your head off. Scoop my black ass over here, pop it up, like. Oh yeah, that's what you're talking about. I'm gonna start off with Pain Was a Person. I'm not going in order, so yeah, let's hop into it. I'm guessing you shouldn't be like, and they ain't loyal to you type shit, you feel me? True. You feel me? Y'all be feeling like a teddy boy. True. So I'll fuck with you. We ain't about the money, what we doing? You know what I'm saying? What's the vibes? Why? Why are you talking to me? And that's what I hate. I was just thinking about this, bro. I would never put myself in a situation with a girl ever. Because if a girl says something, they gonna believe them. Like, it's crazy. Like, I've seen girls lie about the craziest stuff, and the only reason they got caught is because they felt guilty and felt bad to the dude. So it was, you know what I'm saying, she lied and said that he abused and sexually assaulted her and stuff like that. Arrested. She had a fake, she didn't want a fake bruise, it was real bruises, but not by him, and it was just all this other stuff, and then she just said this and said that. All she had to do is open her mouth, and she was believed. People were scolding that nigga, and all of a sudden, she wanted, bro. Shit's stupid, bro. Shit's fucking stupid, bro. Life is not fair if you a man up against a woman verbally. It's really not. It's stupid. Fucking stupid. You would never win. Bitch lied on God and her kids. And it's true. I seen some lie about the craziest things. I seen people lie about who they love the most. You feel me? And I just look like, damn. That's fucked up. Dog, this nigga be talking about what I be talking about. Like, I hate it. This song alone is why I follow you. This is probably his best song. This is his best song on his album already. I don't give a fuck. True, but guess who wasn't shit before a rapper went public with her? You feel me? You know what I'm saying? That rapper was already some shit. She wasn't. Y'all just catch
pushing on late. Speaking on my personal life, my real life, talking about how it's fake, niggas. You ain't me, you ain't in my shoe. You ain't pay dues. Speak. Ain't no gangster, never did none gangster. That was they said. I done seen so many niggas end up dead because they got misled. Ain't got no time for no baby.
I shouldn't have sat there, huh? I don't get fighting, man. You know what I'm saying? Who the fuck? Who the fuck?
Don't take a risk. You can't get a fair bond. Last time I checked, how them charges disappeared. Lack of communication with my bitch. What? Got an economic insecure. I come from the struggle.
I don't know why, but I really can't wait till I let this nigga. That's crazy. You know what I'm saying? That's a small world. It kind of seems like a lot of these women just be, it's kind of coincidental. I'm just saying. I'm just saying. And the world's not even small, so shit.
If I gotta coach a nigga on how to be real, I don't need around me. You can fix your mouth the same, fuck with you at least one time. Well, two times, nah, three times. Couldn't see the end, but I was too blind. See, they probably thought I was running out.
I couldn't see the envy. I was too blind. You know, you ever, like, you know what I'm saying? You ever have somebody you call your brother and people saying something like, nah. You know, feel me? Like, it's your brother. You feel me? You defend him back in the mother. You tell him it's true. You like, damn, bruh. Damn, bruh. Now you thinking about what you gotta do. What could possibly happen? What could the situation lead to between y'all? Like, hard for the next feature and future. First song was crazy. Like I said, probably my favorite song on the album. I don't give a fuck. Let's see what you're talking about. Future's going first? You got it. You got it. You fucking got it. I ain't finna say too much. See, I get niggas is rich, but you know what I'm saying? You can't, this ain't money back, yo. But I feel like Future rapped about getting money and shit like that and hustling and all that stuff too. Way back when, he doing Pluto astronaut status and shit like that. But like, bro, I feel like rappers who buy bitches stuff is just the lamest niggas, bro. Okay, he just said he just bought her a paddock, but then he was saying he ain't love her, he just gave her some status, you feel me? He just fuck with her, you know what I'm saying? Whatever, it's cool, some cool shit. If I'm a rapper, I'm already that nigga, and I'm not even a rapper. I probably don't even have 30% of their cash. But I'm just saying, like, bro, I never in my life had to go do none of that stuff. Like, it was rappers talking about giving bitches, it was a specific watch, but it was just for the head and fucking and shit like that. It's in the song. It's in the song. They be saying that shit like, you know what I'm saying? She did this and I gave her that. Or I gave her this and she, you know what I'm saying, started going crazy. Like, bro, you did that to take a nigga bitch? You did that to break a girl from the club? You did that for all that, bro? Bro, my mouth game is so cold, bro. I don't need it. Like, bro, what? But this is my game. In relationships, I purposely start off trash on purpose. Like, I don't buy a girl nothing for at least the first year and a half in a relationship. Just to see if she that, you know what I'm saying? She there for a nigga. If she fucking with me, you feel me? I don't even go all in. I just be letting her rock. But after that year and some shit, then I go, you know what I'm saying? Then I settle in, huh? Feel me? She gotta earn that shit, you feel me? Fuck. Thank you, yo, for hopping on, because it wasn't ass, but it just the stuff that he was talking about that I wasn't fucking with. Like, I was, but at the same time, wasn't. Like, it was just, like, I can't love her for these hoes who be crabbing, bro. Like, what the fuck?
Less than 50 in her Birkin bin, she ain't one of mine. Added brightness to your glow, they see the difference in your shine. Go dependent, long as you got me, you never in the bind. They say I started someone, I had gave you the lane. And other shit they can't see, cause everything ain't for the ground. I put it down, don't know who need to hear this. Another nigga could never. Spoiling her too easy, make it.
This nigga just said, another nigga could never. He just quoted an... he just quoted a bitch can never. I ain't gonna lie. Money back in relationships, it did change his, like, lingo. And, like, he's more up to date with, like, quotes, I guess, quotations. And, like, you know what I'm saying? Stuff that people say now, you feel me? He's more up to date on that weird shit. Like, that girls be saying. Like, he did a song. Didn't he do a song about a Canava or some shit like that, right? A pussy hoe Canava or some shit like that. Didn't he do that? Like, bro, he's up to date on those, like, feminine lingos and, like, quotes and shit like that and revamping it into, like, his own thing. I guess that's one thing I can say his girl did change him on, because she is heavily OD into that shit. So I guess he, like, her, I guess he, like, peeped and was like, I can do something with that. And but I just, like, that's not what I think it is. Life has changed. Bro, why? Like, come on. See, he getting, I ain't gonna cap, you know, you getting lyrically soft, my nigga. Hey, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? You need to put your big dog hat back on. What the fuck is this? Like, it's, he riding, it ain't, you know what I'm saying? He ass. But it's just like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you bleeding a little bit, you feel me? You bleeding. You bleeding. Huh? Huh? Bro, but the thing is, I do all that without having to buy all that shit. What the, bro, my mouth game is so crazy. Like, bro, all my exes, bro, I promise you, the ones I went, like, OD for it, like, without even having to buy and shit like that. I'm talking about emotionally OD for it. Like, bro, listen. I break standards, my nigga. Like, without having, like, it's crazy. Y'all niggas different. Y'all niggas got it. One of them nights, Moneybagg Yo and Janaiko. Let's see what they talking about. That song is nice. Don't get it twisted. It is crazy. I wonder if Moneybagg Yo was, like, broke and Future was broke and rappers that be buying shit like that was broke. Can they still bag all these bitches that they be pulling? Like, they don't even gotta be, like, the celebrity bitches, but, like, just a fine-ass bitch that's not hood. Like, if he was the still, if he was the same, you know what I'm saying, nigga from the hood on the block, you feel me? He only gotta be selling. Let's just say he's not selling. Let's say he got, like, a regular Nike fit on, you feel me, and some ones. Can he go to the mall or the beach? Or just walk around and bag somebody that's not from the hood. Can you bag a bitch that's not from the hood? That don't know nothing about that hood. Like to her eyes, he got on nothing clothes, like regular brownie clothes. But she on some high end stuff. Like, can he do that? Is his mouth that good though? Like, I wanna see that. I'm curious. Cause, like, it's crazy. If this is a slow song. Janaika, my baby, so this song in the past. I'm gonna listen though. I'm gonna rock. Janaika, my baby though. It's funny when little booty girls know they got little booty and they be like, it's funny. I ain't gonna guess it, but it's just funny. See, the slut her out thing. That's another lingo that's next song. Hey, just say that, it's nothing. I recommend you keep up around me before I fuck up your home. Boy, I can have any bitch I got like and fuck. Made her kiss a friend, I saw the dock in her. We got open and she did. This might be my new TYB song. Hold on. I was talking to a girl once, and she asked me, what is my most guiltiest pleasure? I was joking, because I knew she was around friends. But I just wanted to, like, I knew she was dying laughing when I sent this text, because she had, like, a big-ass pause. At first, she was replying fast. When I said this, she had a big-ass pause. So I know she was showing her friends, and they were laughing, or she was just dying to herself for it. So I was like, she was like, what's your guilty pleasure? And I was like, to be honest, I was like, I just want to hit it back from the back hard and stick my thumb in it. Like, I just want to grip that shit with my thumb and use it as a handle. And I hit that. I was just like, fuck you. I'm going to just say it. That ain't really my guilty pleasure, though. I'm going to keep it a stack. But that shit was funny. Like, I'm the type of nigga, I'm just so random and goofy and stupid, bro. So that was literally the first thing that came to my head. I swear to God. Bro, if I had a long tongue, like, never mind. I was going to say some other foul shit. Some other shit popped in my head, but I never mind. Fuck that shit. Hey. Hey. Especially got the little accent to her. I love me an accent, my nigga. But a girl like that, when they catch you off guard, like you just chilling or you just got done, you know what I'm saying? You like, you look, you tired. You know what I'm saying? She comes to the car, you chilling. You saying? You probably finna go to the crib after, probably go to sleep. And they shoot you with that, lay back. And you like, whoa, shit, say less. It's like, it's surprising. Give her nothing, got the bitch huff, had to tell her what we doing for the public. Next subject, talk to him. Niggas, watch my every move. If you wanna be me, just say that. No, I like her. They ain't for the public, chill out. Nothing, got the bitch huff, had to tell what budget. I don't fuck with rappers, they too buddy buddy. Real estate, now my money making money. Know it tastes good if you see me puff. So dope, I did it before I met puff. I ain't give her nothing, got the... I like your thinking, man. You good, man. You good, man. Bitch huff, had to tell her what we doing for the public. I like his like sound, his ad-libs in the background. I feel he does that the best. You feel me? I don't know. It just like, I ain't gonna say country because he don't got like a hard country like sound in his music. Like in terms of like his literature, how you speak, it ain't as country as like niggas in the country can really be. Unless like him on the mic just sound different. You know what I'm saying? But from the music, at least he don't sound like it. So it just sounds smooth. Talk to him. Like him in the background, that little ad-lib, it's smooth. It rides. A gangster's paying God to the main attraction, you feel me? Who made this beat? I hear this voice a lot. I don't know if this is the same girl that's doing everybody's like producer intros. Or this, they just all sound like, or they just trying to sound like, you know what I'm saying? It's been around for years. Ran into some dead ends, rerouted, made away, tennis chain, ring white. It's fucking bothering me. Good shit though for the instrumental. If y'all know where the instrumental came from, you know. Watch light on the ice today. Street nigga from the M, that's where you gotta keep a cat. Bullets don't discriminate. Just I can't stop thinking about it. The thing is, Moneybagg don't even probably know. He probably just heard the beat and was like, this shit fire. His producer definitely used this instrumental from somewhere, though. But where, though? I don't know. But, so my head. It's like he, like, put, like, muffliness over it and, like, tone it down and bring up, like, bass. Y'all hear that little, like, it's like a, I guess, humming or whistling or... It's like that was louder on the original and everything else in the background was, like, lower. But it's slowly coming to mind as like I more and more think about it. Confine you, trying to put me in the middle cause my nigga robbed you. Told you not to fuck with him, but you act like you had to. I've been in the same situation. And then a dude that I didn't want to tell to slip on another nigga, he was like, oh, you acting fake, you choosing sides. I'm like, nigga, no, nigga, this is your problem. this grown man business. You feel me? You know that's what bringing another man in this. You feel me? Handle it out rationally. Plus, he's in a losing situation. He tried to pull it to a house, you know, those houses that got the high grasses and the steep stairs, like that's like Danny, you walking up type shit. Like a, it was like a two-story house with an attic, and they all had blinds on them. If you wanted to pull up on a house like that in the hood, nigga, they don't even like the doors at night for a reason, because they're not there prepared. My nigga, if I would have been like, all right, here's the attic, he would have pulled up just to got laid out. Like, he probably wouldn't even made it out the car before he, like, you know what I'm saying? I saved his life. Like, my nigga, I don't think he knew the type of house he was pulling up to and who he got robbed by. Because if you would have, like, the stairs, like, right, I'm telling you, this stairs is like you then are going up a hill, a steep ass hill. Then you gotta go up another staircase of flights. Like, they could have been in the attic looking out the window, could have got blown from the attic. Any other, like, bro, there is just so many different ways he could have got, oh, man, it's just, if people would have known what I was doing, helping this nigga out, and but all deals look bad because I'm not gonna give you this nigga address. That's not even my business. Niggas don't know, bro. Okay, I see you with the flow. Streets ain't for everybody. That's why they made the curve, nigga. If you ain't. Jesus. I probably had a few of them calls. I ain't gonna hold you. Young. It started young, too. You know how you just. Shit just kept piling up with people. Problems every time you turn around the corner, you live a hard knock. Free my niggas, heard you. Heard you got a pay up box. Getting known is one thing, staying known is another. Huh? This nigga's different. This nigga's devious. This nigga's devious. I love his flow and sound in that song too. It was hitting. I ain't even gonna lie to you. I'm impressed. Certified Neptune's next. Yee hee. See what you talking about. What he got with Pharrell going on? What do y'all with Pharrell going on? Yeah. I won't go like David Ruffin. Hey, popping him every time I can. I know you want to leave me, but I refuse to let you go. You fiery. If I gotta beg you, please, for your sympathy, I don't mind, cause you mean that. What y'all know? Y'all don't know nothing about that, but I don't act like you know what you know. You don't know nothing about that, nigga. Anybody coming to see you, oh, this nigga, they're fighting. His references and, like, his quotations of, like, known, like, memes, I guess you could still call them, whatever. He's on point with staying like up to date and knowing what's like known and like what you can relate to and people will catch on to. He's good at that. I come from where they tell people you change when you expand, and I can get you knocked off while my feet in the same plan. Bitches on my pants. That's like his third time saying something like that, but differently. Cause I remember last time he said he had his hands in his pockets and he said something about his niggas someone. I forgot exactly what he said, but he said somebody's hand in his pockets, his niggas can do the work. This time he said he got his feet in the sand and he can still get knocked off. Basically like the same thing, but like different wording. He does that. He did that a few times. Flay the same the first time. Flay, he did it also on like different like projects.
If your loyalty don't match mine,
I'm gonna be honest. I did not at all expect Pharrell to actually be on this song. I thought he was gonna produce it. You know how he just had a producer and a feature sometimes? That's what I thought this was. I didn't expect him to actually hop on the beat. That threw me off. He kind of sounded like Kanye. And I was even more thrown off. What the fuck? I'm going to keep it a stack. He got that old school flow for the show. Like back in the day when he used to just wear Adidas tracksuits, the little kangaroo hats, and just cruising down the street in my six. Like he still got that NWA, Run DMC, you know, some back then type of style of sound. My ear, you see that with my side bitch, and I got that shit on CPN. I don't want to hear what you got for your side bitch, cause that shit ass. Bipolar Virgo, money bag, yo. See what you talking about? I need some monies. Where that from? You the only person you trust to count your money. You have a long, depending on what you do, you have a long time to go to count that money. I know some people who got teams of money. I mean, they got teams of people to count their money. You ever seen that you ever seen the old Biggie Smalls movie? He needed like six men to count his dough money. That nigga was different in New York. Fuck what they talking about. I'm top five for sure. I stamped it. Keep in mind the ad lib said I stamped it, as in singularly I said that. You seeing y'all top five? Let me know. Comment down below. Damn, nigga, your plug game is 8. How old is she? Like 35, 40? Nah, so he old as shit, though. He ain't old, but he an OG. Put it like that. How old is he? I'm curious. He moved like that uncle that you know that got money, but you don't know what he do exactly. He's like that type of uncle in the rap game. You feel me? He's one of them niggas. Look how they feel. When I trust, count it up. Hold it up. Keep on you, bro. Pull me up. Pick your side. All this money, I'm the only one to trust to count it up. Hold me up. Just hold me up. Pull me up. Pick your side. Huh? The streets don't love you, they just take you away from the people who do. Yikes. Yikes. True. See, I have to, because I went through something in my health that I literally, like, you know, I can't risk it. I went through some crazy health issues, like crazy health issues. So, like, I kind of have to, you feel me? A nigga know when to like be smart still. And Bipolar Virgo. That was the last two. That was the last one I reacted to, man. You feel me? What y'all think about this song? Donkey is trash. Follow me in the comment down below. I'm curious in your thoughts and opinion. Moneybagg Yo is nice. Like I said, he is nice. He's that nigga. He can rap. Like, you feel me? I fuck with Moneybagg Yo. I like his hustle, like his Gronky said. COVID, you know what I'm saying? Pandemic and do shit for him. He still held it down. Still got that bread. Still was making that cheddar, getting cash. But you do what you gotta do. Does that make sense? But you do what you gotta do, and I respect him. I respect him as a man. I do, I really do. As an artist, he is next as well. He is smooth on the mic. He is really smooth with it. He is different. He's that guy. You feel me? And I like that talk. You feel me? Slick with it. My only downside to him was like, he really keep up to date with all this new shit, this new lingo, this new quotes, and like, you know what I'm saying? Especially the female shit, like. And I think it's because of his girl, because like, she's deep into that, and she be like, with, I think she hang with the city girls and shit like that, and they the ones that be like starting some of it, so it's like, your family is like, he going, you know what I'm saying, being around it, and I feel like his girl say shit like that a lot, it just rubs off on him, so it's like, I ain't blaming him, but it's just like crazy. And he talk about some other shit, like spending to do to, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, I'm done. I'm gonna probably, I'm gonna talk your head off. Money Bag, yo, against his pain, he did his thing. I'm not mad at it. I know he's nice. I already know he's nice. I just wanted to check it out and pee for myself, see what he's talking about personally. But yeah, man, what's your thoughts up here on this song? What is your favorite song on here? If I didn't react to it, comment it down below and I got you. Family, so yeah. Let me shut up, talk your head up without further ado, man. I'll give this a solid 8 out of 10. I just hate the fact he keep talking about that shit. 8 out of 10. He's that guy. I would say 9 because I've been to Walker Homes. And I've been where he's been at and stuff and shit like that. I've been around there. But I don't do favoritism. I don't give a fuck that shit. You feel me? So, yeah, man. Like I said, last time for the shit show. I'm about to, I'm talking down, talking your heads off. Hit the subscribe button. Follow if you follow with the K. You feel me? Why not, right? Follow with the K. Hit the subscribe button. It's free. Everybody love free shit. You feel me? Without further ado, my name is D.D. Will, and I hope you enjoy just the hey, you feel me?